VMware Tools allows the VM to perform better because it enhances the interaction from the guest OS to the ESX host. It also enables quite a lot of features which we find useful as a VMware administrator. Hello everyone, welcome back, and this is Ibrahim Qureshi. Today we are going to discuss VMware Tools. I'm going to show you how we can install VMware Tools and the benefits of VMware Tool. The important thing is it is also a crucial part of one of the memory management techniques. If you have VMware Tools running, one of the memory management techniques depends on this tools to be available and running. So let's get started. Just want to remind you to subscribe to my channel. Please subscribe to my channel and hit the notification button. Share it with anyone who you think might benefit from it. And thanks a lot for the people who have subscribed. I've reached just over 300 subscribers, and I post at least 2 sessions a week. So be sure to hit the notification button so that you don't miss out. So today's topic, again, as I said, is VMware Tools. We also call it VM Tools. We are going to discuss benefits of VMware Tools and how to check if we are running up-to-date version of VMware Tools. How to install the VMware Tools as well, we'll cover today. So what is VMware Tools? VMware Tool is a suite of utilities that enhances the performance of the virtual machine's guest operating system and improves management of the virtual machine. So in simple words, it basically enhances the performance. And one tip for you, if you have running VMware Tools and you upgrade the ESX host, the new ESX host version will come with its new enhanced tools anyway. So what will happen is you might find that the tools will show up as outdated. So you will need to reinstall the VMware Tools whenever you upgrade the do your ESX patching and upgrade the ESX host, or you reinstall the ESX host with a newer version of ESX. So you need to remember to do that. You can install using Windows Easy Install, and also we have Linux Easy Install feature to do the installation. So the benefits, again, benefits performance. As I said, guest VM can be interactive with the host, which I'll show you how it can be interactive. One of the feature you'll see is you can check the IP address of the guest operating system from the host just by clicking the VM. You can shut down the guest OS, you can restart the guest OS. So it's not like a, you know, power off where you kind of pull the plug off and it just goes off, you know. So you can be you can have a graceful shutdown and a graceful restart in VMware terms. Also, as I said, it is a very important feature from VMware, which is for the memory management technique. I have discussed memory management techniques in my previous session, which was session 12. If you have missed it, you'll find at the end of this video on the left side, you'll find the previous session, and on the right side, usually you'll find the next ones available or the general overview of these sessions which I'm doing. So be sure to click on the left video. You'll find the previous session 12, which takes you deep dive into the memory management techniques of VMware, and it's a very important session. I would strongly recommend to go through and have a look at the different techniques. We have 4 techniques, and I have gone through each one of them as a deep dive. So VMware Tool is a crucial part of enabling ballooning. So VMware ballooning is one of the memory management techniques, as I said. So you will need to have it installed for the ESX host to use this feature. Okay, let's get started without wasting any more time. Let me open my ESX host, my vCenter, sorry. So we are on our vCenter now, and today I'm going to use IMVM2 as a test demo VM. And the very first thing over here you can see is you have a message here, VMware Tools is not running on the virtual machine, on this virtual machine. And then over here, install virtual machine. So that's basically it's saying you to click on it and it'll do it. But the again, another thing you can see is DNS name is not given, IP address is not given. If the VMware Tools is running, these will be populated. And the most important things, VMware Tools, VM Tools. Over here, you'll see whether it's running or not. So there are two things here, not installed, not running and not installed. What this means is you could be having it running, you could be having it installed, but even if it installed, it could not be running because it's outdated or it someone have manually turned it off. And I have some of the database team members are quite notorious with these. They want to disable the drivers because it sucks out the memory from the VM and gives it to the host. So they don't want their VM to participate in the VMware ballooning mechanism technique. So basically they disable it, but it creates a lot of other performance issues because the VMware tools are essential for giving better performance for your OS. So just because of that feature, if you guys are doing that, stop doing that, I'm telling you now, because that's not going to give you any benefit. It's going to take away your performance really. Anyway, so to install VMware tools, the official way, you need to right click on the VM and then you go to guest OS, and then if you select install VMware tools, this is how you install it. So you select install VMware tools. If you have it already, if you have already got it, you'll see upgrade, but as now it has picked up that it is not got it installed, that's why, as you can see, these options have grayed out automatically. Yeah, before it wasn't grayed out, now it is grayed out. So let's click install VMware tools. So it will basically essentially this mounts an ISO on the guest operating system. We just need to go in there and then install it. So it's asking you whether you want to mount it. Click mount, and then now what I'll do is I'll log into the VM. So I have opened the VMRC. So let's open the computer, and on CD drive you can see it has got the disk mounted. So you can say install or run. Click yes. Another quick thing I wanted to show you while it's loading is if you right click here and if you go to power, you can't see these two options enabled. So these two options will be only enabled if you have VMware tools running. So as I said, this allows you to do a graceful restart and a graceful shutdown. It's as if you're asking the you're logging into the OS and asking it to shut down, right click start, sorry, right click start, and then you know, power off, restart or whatever. But if you do it from here, reset or power off, it's like pulling off the plug. So again, that's another, as I said in the slides as well, that's only enabled if you're having VMware tools running. Okay, let's get started here. We are ready to do this installation. Click next. So leave it on typical, doesn't matter. Install. So that's how simple it is. Another thing you need to be mindful is installing VMware tool is is going to require a reboot of the guest operating system. So you need to be mindful that when you're installing this, if it's a production server you're installing it on, you need to have an outage time range for doing this. If you're upgrading it, depending on what drivers are being updated, you will need to check whether it will need a reboot or not. So as this training is for people who want to really go and dive in to, you know, working in a production environment, I want to be telling you anything that is cautious or a caution to you that if you're installing this on a production environment, then be sure to write the change first and arrange a downtime for this. Also, I would suggest if you're installing it on any Linux or any older version, this is 2016, so I'm not 2019, so I'm not bothered. But if you're doing it on any OS other than the latest version, highly recommend, I do it myself, highly recommend to take a snapshot beforehand. So I have done a session on how to take a snapshot and everything, so I preach what I use as well. So I forgot to do it this time because I was in a flow, but normally write the change and in the change mention that you will be taking a snapshot to protect yourself if the installation of VMware tools does create any problems, which may happen because some of the Linux versions I have seen in the past will create problems. So all you have to do is, as I said, right click, take snapshot and say what it's for, VMware tools upgrade, and then click OK. So that will allow you to revert back to a previous state. But at this moment we are quite late anyway, we started the installation. So but nevertheless, what I want to say is take the snapshot before let's go through it again. So the proper process is, obviously, as I said, this will require a reboot. So you need to write a change or an incident saying I'm going to install this because we don't have VMware tools running. Once the change is approved, first step in the change is to cover yourself so you can revert back the change. So anything you do, you need to be having a thorough plan of reversion. So you can say I'm going to take a snapshot, and if we do have any problems, we are going to revert the snapshot back to the original state. So it will be as if it was never installed. So I have done a session on VMware snapshots. I think it was session number 10. Be sure to have a look. Can't remember the session number, but be sure to have a look at that to understand snapshots and how you can leverage snapshots and use it. I think I did a really nice demo on how to recover a Linux password. If you're interested in that, just try and find it and have a look. So let me pause for a while. I think it's taking a little bit longer than expected. So, and then I'll resume once this installation is finished. We can have. So let's click on finish. You must, as I said, you must restart the system for configuration changes made to the VMware tools to take effect. Click yes. So it's just my test VM, so I'm going to reboot this. Hi guys, welcome back. So the virtual machine has rebooted successfully. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to the vCenter and select the VM. On the VM, on the first instance, you can see that the DNS name has been picked up. So the VMware tools is able to communicate to the guest OS. It has also picked up an IP address, which is 192.168.1.208. In the VMware tools, you can see here it says running, and it also says the version, which is 10341, and it says current. So if the ESX server is upgraded, then it may say running or out of date, or it may say out of date or you know, not running sometimes. So it depends obviously on the situation, but obviously in my case, after installing VMware Tools, I can get the IP address information, DNS name. It has picked up that it is running the current version, and it says that it is running as well. So it's when sometimes you see that when it is booting and it is in a process of booting, this will say current, but on here it will say not running because the system is not fully booted. Another thing I want to show you in power options is, now if you come here, these two options were disabled and they are enabled now. So with the help of VMware Tools, you should be able to gracefully shut down the OS or restart the OS. So that's about it, guys. I don't want to pull this further. So it was a really nice topic. Another important feature which gets enabled often as soon as you install VMware Tools is if the memory management techniques, one of the memory management techniques, which is ballooning, ballooning driver kicks in, and if the VMware tools are working, then it will be VMware will be leveraging those memory management technique as well. So let's conclude. You can reach out to me if you want to discuss any topic in detail at Ibrahim Qureshi on Twitter, and you can follow my blog, which is Ibrahim Qureshi. Question of the day today: what is the advantage of VMware Tools? So we have gone through so many advantages, just mentioned a couple of them which you think are useful. Just leave the comment below, guys, and don't forget to subscribe. Enjoy watching and keep sharing. Cheers, bye.